Let me show you an app that's available for Mac, Linux, and Windows that's extremely useful, plus it's extremely inexpensive. So let's go check it out. The application that I'm talking about is called Radar, and what it does, it gives you a small widget like the one you're looking at right now, and it gives you a lot of useful data that you can connect to. Now, it just doesn't stop there. The best part about it is that you can also connect API. If you know a little bit about development or just how to get around, you can practically connect to any system that you need to get information or to trigger something. Now, it sounds a little bit tricky, but let's get started with this. For starters, you can connect to all of this, which is already available data that you can connect to easily. So if you need to know your cryptocurrencies, stocks, ETFs, Twitter, YouTube, subscriber count, your PayPal balance, your Wise, Shopify, WooCommerce, and all these, they're available as of now just to trigger them really easy. Let me give you an example. If I want to connect to YouTube, well, it's my YouTube channel, connect to YouTube, and you're good to go. So it's extremely useful. Google Analytics, again, connect to your Google Analytics account and connect all of this, and it's extremely useful in that sense. Now, if you have something that's not available yet, you can go ahead and request it, but it doesn't stop there. That's just the data that you can connect to really easily. Now, you can see right here that I have connected. I want to know what the US dollar is in the difference with Mexican peso. Now, you're going to say, hey, you know what? I mean, that's not useful. Even Mac has this inbuilt. Of course, that's simple. But can it tell me what the subscriber count is? Can it tell me what my Wise balance is? Now, it's zero because I'm displaying the euros one, not the USD. And I've connected a couple of tricks, which is Product Hunt Run. I've connected the API to run Product Hunt, which is a browse AI system that I'm using for automating. Let me give you an example. If I click on this pencil, this is how I automated. I have the option to post or get, and I have params, authorization, header, and body to connect to API systems. Let me give you an example. This is the one I've created, and you can see right now, let me go ahead and refresh this. I'm gonna run it from Radar, I mean, using that app, so I don't have to come in here and browse AI and do it manually or do something like that, okay? So it was run 18 minutes ago. Now I'm gonna use Radar, and let me go back here to the main one, and I'm gonna run it. So I'm gonna refresh it here, and it's gonna rerun it, all right? So remember, 18 minutes, it hasn't been run right now. Let me go ahead and refresh it. And here we go, a few seconds ago, it just ran this automation system manually. So I'm searching around my computer, I'm working, and if I need to run something manually, I can do so here. So just like that, I was able to run Radar, I mean, browse AI. Now I can also do the same with Pavli Connect. So let's just say that I'm using this as a workflow, and Pavli Connect is similar to Zapier, to Make, to Integrally, and all those. I can trigger this flow via the webhook. So again, in Radar, so let me go ahead and start this one. It's this one right here, but I'll go ahead and start it again. I'll click on this little plus button, and I'll name this Pavli Test. Okay, and I'm gonna post, I'm not gonna get because I'm sending data, and I'm gonna get the webhook URL. Let's go back into Radar. And then the params are the label and value. Now, this is extremely useful because we can do things with it, like automate different kind of things. So for example, let me go ahead and recapture this webhook. Okay, there we go. I'm starting from scratch. I've added the webhook and I'm gonna run it right now. And I'm gonna tell it the value is, I'll say this is trigger and I'll say positive. I mean, this is just something I want to do. You can do anything you like, okay? There we go. So it's sending the data. Pavli should capture that data right now. There we go. It just received it, trigger, and it's positive, okay? Because that's what I want to use. And with that value, I want to do some automation. So in Pavli Connect, I can use a router. For example, filter one. If it contains positive, well, it's going to run this workflow. If it contains negative, it'll run this other workflow. And again, in Radar, I can connect this one to positive. For example, here it is added, positive, and I can make another one for negative. So if I want to run one or the other, I can do so with this system. But it's super easy, and we can add the icon manually like I've done. So if you want to trigger this, you can do it via the Radar system. Let me go ahead and stretch this and run a workflow with the API or get information from other type of systems. So let's just say that you have an uptime monitor and you wanna know here if it's up or down. Well, you can do so with this. And we can trigger this to refresh every certain time. So for example, I did that one manually, but I'll hit the pencil and I can do this. For example, I'll go next and I can go ahead and make it run every minute, every 5 minutes, 15, 30, etc., up to one day. The only one that's missing, I think they should add, is the 12-hour one. I mean, it's half a day. We need that one, right? So I hope Radar adds that there. But I like how it's super advanced in this system that we can capture simple data that they have already here, or if you want to make it more complex with the API. Now, right now, there's a lifetime deal that I think it's extremely cheap for what you could do with Radar. I mean, for me, the really plus about Radar is that we can use API. Like you saw, I'm able to trigger different kind of things or grab information from different type of places via API. So I don't have to wait for them to actually implement it. I can use the API. Now, you're gonna get in the Pro Plus plan. So there's also notifications in Radar. So let me give you an example. In this Weiss balance, so here it is. Next. It could run, for example, every day, never, etc. And there's a, where is that? No, you can run it from over here. In this system, if I want to add Wise again, I can notify me when balance is. So for example, more than, less than, or equal to. So it gives you that really benefit of getting notifications if it goes over certain balance or goes under a balance or for other type of situations. If you hit the subscriber count of 20,000, well, you can get notified right away with Radar. So you get all of that, this widget that I think is extremely useful for $29. It's a one-time purchase. You pay once and you use it forever. And like I said before, it's available for Windows, Mac, and Linux. And there you go. If you want to grab it, the link will be provided in the description. And that's a wrap.